Please note this video will discuss the most recent episode of Life is Strange. There are some mature themes in Life is Strange, such as suicide, murder, and possible sexual assault. Please proceed with caution. When the most recent episode of Life is Strange ended, Max was left in a hopeless situation. Mr. Jefferson killed Chloe, he is involved with Rachel's death and the non-consensual pictures taken of other girls, and Max is drugged and can't rewind to warn Chloe or anyone else. In addition, as each episode tackles a day in this series, episode 5 is Friday. Friday is when the hurricane hits, which seemingly will destroy Arcadia Bay. How is Max going to get out of Mr. Jefferson's clutches and save the day? She won't do it by herself. Instead, Joyce, David, and whoever else you are on good terms with will save Max. Episode 4 went back to Chloe's room several times and emphasized two things. One, Joyce knew it was there, duh, and Max and Chloe put their evidence together there. Specifically, the evidence that points to where the barn is. We know from the teaser that Max will end up in the barn. When neither Chloe nor Max check in the morning, Joyce will be worried. She worries about Chloe, and while Chloe may complain, Max would call Joyce saying something like, car broke down, where at X? If neither Max nor Chloe check in, Joyce will go looking. The first stop would be Chloe's room, where the evidence is laid out. The developers have also gone to great lengths to emphasize how much Joyce cares about Chloe and Max in any timeline. She takes care of them and she worries about them. Max can even receive texts from Joyce about the plot and Chloe. Joyce would see the barn's location and decide to check it out, as it's her only lead to where Max and Chloe could be. As for David, he is probably not a horrible person. Aggressive, paranoid, but in my playthrough, he told Max how he would do anything to help Chloe when he left the house. He's also ex-military, and if Joyce is worried, she'd call him. He'd know what to do. As for everyone else, Max spent the entire time at the Vortex party asking around for Nathan. When Max doesn't show up the next day, the people who care will be worried for her. And if you warn Victoria, she's going to be involved too. Victoria can carry a grudge, but she's not stupid. Especially if Nathan is missing too. No matter how you are with Victoria, if Max disappears after warning Victoria, she may have a lead. Dana is a special case, which will be another video later. Kate would help as much as she can. Brooke, Warren, Alyssa, and others would try to save their friend. They may not be able to stop Mr. Jefferson, his allies, or the tornado on their own, but they can at least come in to save Max, and Joyce will lead the way.